It was a dark and stormy night. What the? Oh no. I've been infected. Well, actually not me, my computer. And if I don't deal with this situation in the next few minutes, I have a sneaking suspicion all my files will be destroyed. Where is it? My computer's been infected with a computer virus. Now you may ask, how can a computer get sick? I mean, it's a machine, right? Well, a computer virus is very similar to a virus that would infect you or me. A biological virus is a submicroscopic parasite. There's not much to it. It's essentially a strand of genetic material wrapped in a protective coating made of protein. By itself, a virus is inert, lifeless. But allow it to enter a living cell, and well, you've got trouble. You see, once a virus enters a living cell, its protein coat dissolves, releasing its genetic material. This genetic material is actually a set of chemical instructions on how to make a virus. The host cell reads these instructions and commences to produce another virus. This reproductive process can repeat itself until thousands of viruses are produced. These new viruses then leave the host cell to infect other nearby cells, sometimes killing the host cell and the host organism in the process. A computer virus is similar in many respects, but instead of being made up of organic genetic material like a biological virus, a computer virus is made up of a bunch of these, ones and zeros. This is binary code, also known as machine language. It's the only language computers understand. All computer programs, no matter what programming language they're written in, have to be converted into binary code before the computer can run them. And that's exactly what a computer virus is. A computer program. A few lines of instructions written in binary code. But how did this program get into my computer in the first place? And why is it threatening to destroy everything in sight? Well, computer viruses are parasitic, much like their biological cousins. Most of them are just a few lines of instructions tacked on to the beginning or end of some other program. Like that hot new game that's been making the rounds at the office. Or that piece of web browsing software you downloaded from the internet. Whenever you run the infected program on your computer, the virus's instructions are carried out too. These instructions typically have three stages. The first stage orders the computer to give the virus information on its surroundings. This information includes what type of computer the virus is in, what software programs are in the system, and so on. That lets the virus know what other programs are available to infect. Once the virus knows where it is and what's available, it proceeds to borrow a page from its biological cousins. It instructs the computer to make a viral copy and insert it into another program in the system. This process is repeated every time the infected program is executed. Before you know it, every program in the computer is infected. Then you, unaware that any of this is going on, email your newly infected word processing program to your boss's workstation at home, the same machine he uses to email his new screensaver program to all his friends. This is how a computer virus spreads. This wouldn't be so bad if it weren't for the computer virus's third stage. Now, the third stage often isn't carried out until the virus replicates itself a set number of times or when the computer's clock reaches a certain date, like Friday the 13th. This built-in delay gives a virus a chance to travel far and wide undetected. When the delay is over, the third stage is activated. The virus instructs the host computer to erase disks, destroy programs, randomly rearrange data. In short, to wreak whatever havoc dreamed up by the virus's creator. So what can be done? Well, again, we look to our own bodies for the answer. You see, we have a built-in defense system to deal with foreign invaders like viruses. It's called the immune system. The immune system is made up of trillions of specialized cells that seek out and destroy foreign organisms in our body. This is an immune system in a box. It's a computer antiviral program, and it works very much like our own immune system does. Most antiviral programs prevent infection by searching computer files for traces of binary code that are distinctive to a particular virus. These traces are called viral signatures. They're like a fingerprint. Once a signature has been identified, the antiviral program will proceed to remove the infection. Many antiviral programs will then take up residence in the computer's memory and continue to scan for viruses. But no antiviral program can protect you against all computer viruses. Just too many new strains sprouting up all the time. Which is why it's important to keep up with the latest versions of antiviral software out there. But you know, the best protection against a computer virus is prevention. And that means practicing safe computing. Avoid promiscuous downloading of programs over the telephone lines. Watch for symptoms of infection, like unusual error messages or reduced space in memory. Keep an archive of clean backup files. And above all, religiously scan borrowed disks for viruses before you use them.